and I do Eleanor's Story, An American Girl in Hitler's Germany. I went to Cal State Fullerton, which is sort of where all the Disney princesses go in Southern California. It's right near Disneyland. While I was studying there, tech to show at the Winnipeg Fringe and fell in love and wanted to do that instead of going up and auditioning in LA every day. So I just needed a story to tell, and fortunately I have a very fascinating story in my family, that of my grandmother's experience growing up as an American in Nazi Berlin.
And I understand this was taken from a book that your grandmother wrote?
Yes, so my grandmother wrote a book of the same title, Eleanor's Story, back in 1999, and at the time it was a really big deal. I think it's still on one of the top 10 memoirs about World War II, and she got to do like a press tour in her 70s. It was a magical experience for her.
I understand, too, that this is not the first time you showed the play in Winnipeg. It's been here before.
No, yeah, I brought it twice before, in 2015 and in 2016. But I have a sequel to the show now, and I was going to bring it, but unfortunately, every year I perform Eleanor's Story, it feels like it becomes more relevant, and the Ukraine conflict began in the earlier part of this year, and this just felt relevant all over again and felt important to bring it back.
So what kind of reaction have you got from the audience? Did people talk about how they enjoyed it or brought back bad memories of that they were in the war too?
Well, I haven't been speaking to as many people post-show this year because there was a little scheduling mishap and I was put into a 45-minute slot instead of an hour slot. So the poor company after me has to scramble to get in. So I've been so busy, you know, clearing my show out, I haven't really had time to speak to people, but I've gotten a lot of really kind standing ovations and people, you know, waving to me as I exit. So, and if they see me on the street, they've been, I don't know, Winnipeg's the best. We all talk about you guys here. And everywhere in the world.
And have you written any other Fringe plays before? This is your first Fringe play you've written?
This was the first Fringe play. I wrote a sequel to the show called Eleanor's Story, Life After War. I also did a big departure. I did a show called B-Movie Bash, where I played a horror hostess, and me and other comedians would screen bad films and roast them live, kind of like Mystery Science Theater 3000 meets Elvira. And I did a children's show with folk tales that featured female protagonists. But I'm hoping to write a new show, actually, about Vampira, who is the original horror hostess in the 1950s, and she's a very fascinating, forgotten historical figure.
And would you ever consider co-production with other... I know some people do co-producing with other performers,
yeah,
directors. And the
it does get lonely doing solo shows, but it's hard to pass up how economical it is to just travel with one person. So, I don't know. Maybe, I mean, I'm open to it. I just don't want to have to audition.
So where else is this play shown around North America?
North America, I did it, I've only ever done it in Winnipeg and Edmonton. This summer, I really lucked out. I just did Ottawa Fringe, and I'm heading to Saskatoon and Edmonton and Victoria next. But mostly I've been doing the show in Australia the past 7 years, except during the pandemic. They've actually been my best audiences. There's so many post-war immigrants there, and they've been just very kind to the show. And I've done it in Edinburgh, at the Edinburgh Fringe, 3 years in a row. So it's found legs in all the commonwealths, everywhere but the U.S. generally.
And do you always stick to this genre about true stories, or would you ever do a non-true story?
Well, the kids show I did, the international folk tales, was all fiction. But I think I've kind of found, I have a special niche with biographies and shedding light on unique stories. So I don't know. I kind of have an affinity for that. So maybe one day. Creative writing's fun, but I like, there's so many interesting real stories in the world that deserve, I think, to be put on stage.
So would you say this is your career then, in theater?
Yeah, I mean, this is generally what I do. During the pandemic, I went more into civil service because I couldn't perform. I worked the mass vaccine site at Disneyland along with other Disney princesses. I wasn't a Disney princess, but there was Disney princesses there.